In the criminal justice system, the people are represented by two separate yet equally important groups. The police who investigate crime.
And the SJW district attorneys who don't prosecute the offenders. These are their stories. Hello everyone. We here at the Prosecution Channel are strong supporters of the traditional American Christmas. If you support Christmas, then smash that like button and subscribe to this YouTube channel. Now I've got some news for you from California. You see, California must have made it on the Santa's naughty list because it's about to get a huge lump of coal. I think for a lot of Americans, when they think about gang members, they instinctively think of California, specifically Los Angeles. After all, this was the scene of the birthplace of gangster rap. It was NWA and Snoop Dogg. This is the whole origins of the Bloods versus the Crips. I mean, everyone's heard about Compton, right? What about Grand Theft Auto, San Andreas? Do you remember that? Of course, all of these entertainment products, they were all based on the reality of what was going on the streets of Los Angeles. Gang warfare, drive-by shootings, graffiti, armed robberies, the sale, trafficking, and distribution of drugs. These were all things that accompanied gang culture in California, and do so to this very day. The gangs haven't disappeared, they haven't gone away, people are still consuming drugs all over the place in the state of California. To respond to the threat posed by gangs in major police departments like the Los Angeles Police Department and the San Francisco Police Department, they began to collect intelligence on gangs, keep track of gang rosters, become experts on the gangs, because that's what you need to do in order to dismantle this type of problem. And during the past couple of decades, that's what law enforcement did. They went after these gangs. They made sure that the rule of law was upheld. Remember, gangs tend to be a problem only in highly impoverished areas, and the sort of people that gang members target are usually either other gang members or the people who live in these highly impoverished areas. Gang members, perhaps more so than any other type of group of criminals, pose a unique risk specifically to poor people. So law enforcement getting tough on gangs is just good policy, or at least it was. Now we're in 2019 though, and things have changed. You see, we've seen the rise of the NPCs.
Drug war bad. Own some lives matter. Laws are racist.
So the NPCs elect Chesa Bowden to be the San Francisco District Attorney. Now, I don't know if you've watched my other videos talking about Chesa Bowden, but if you haven't, just to give you a short summary, Chesa Bowden was a guy who was raised by a terrorist who bombed and killed people. He was raised by this terrorist because both of his parents were in prison, because they were also terrorists, and they killed a police officer during an armed robbery they were committing. In addition to being associated with terrorists, Chesa Bowden is an ardent communist. He worked for the Hugo Chavez administration, and I'm not kidding, he went to Venezuela and worked for Hugo Chavez and supported Hugo Chavez policies, as well as communist current dictator Nicolas Maduro, who's ran that country into the complete ground. The Hunger Games-like atmosphere that exists in Venezuela today was put in the place there thanks to people like San Francisco District Attorney and terrorist sympathizer Chesa Bowden. Now, in my other video, I talked about how Chesa Bowden was going to take on the task of cleaning up the streets of San Francisco, of dealing with the hobo apocalypse that's going on in there, which was going to be to stop prosecuting people for public urination. and to no longer arrest people who were blocking a sidewalk, with it unspecified if that meant that you could block a sidewalk for perpetuity. These policies didn't seem to be a very good idea for a city that was absolutely infested with hobo zombies. These policies actually seemed like they would make problems worse. Well, guess what, people? Now Chesa Bowden's set his sights on more serious types of crimes. According to the San Francisco Chronicle, Chesa Bowden promises to put an end to filing what are known as gang enhancements. These are crimes that pertain specifically to gang members who commit crimes. They allow for example, gang members who threaten or assault people on behalf of a street gang to receive mandatory incarceration or be prosecuted for higher level felonies rather than misdemeanors. Why is Chesa Bowden proposing this? Well, according to him, gang enhancements are infused with racism.
It's racist!
Which seems awfully strange, since there's nothing in the language of the gang enhancements that indicates that they can only be filed against members of certain races. In fact, a group that I think stands to benefit from this sort of policy change in California would be none other than the Aryan Brotherhood. I think it's fair to say that the Aryan Brotherhood is a racist criminal street gang. I mean, you constantly hear the NPCs calling Tucker Carlson a Nazi and a white supremacist, but I've watched Tucker Carlson's show enough to know he doesn't have any SS lightning bolt tattoos. He doesn't have Hail Hitler tattoos. He doesn't think that Adolf Hitler was one of the greatest men to ever live. He doesn't hail Hitler on his show, and he doesn't use swastikas all the time. But these are all things that are true of the Aryan Brotherhood. But no, you can't charge them with any sort of gang crimes because that would be racist, right?
It's racist!
But that's just kooky San Francisco. I know what you're probably thinking. Didn't earlier he say California, not just San Francisco? But guess what, people? If you live in Los Angeles, you're probably getting a big fat lump of coal as well. You see, the guy who used to be the San Francisco district attorney, George Gasson, the guy who predated Chesa Bowden and post-dated Democratic presidential primary failure Kamala Harris, George Gasson, he's currently running for Los Angeles district attorney. When George Gasson was the San Francisco district attorney, he charged gang members. He went after them. He tried to dismantle gangs. But apparently now that's changed. According to the same San Francisco Chronicle article, George Gasson said he would stop charging gang enhancements and support statewide efforts to repeal the law. Given the fact that majority of the population of California lives in Los Angeles County or the Bay Area, and given that other California counties, not all of them, but a lot of them, are likely to copy the policies that San Francisco and Los Angeles are pursuing, it seems like the end of California gang cases is on the horizon. This is great if you're a California gang member. If you're a Sereno or Norteño, two of the most powerful gangs in the United States. If you're MS-13, Aryan Brotherhood. If you're a Blood or a Crip. These are great for you. But if you are a poor person who lives in the neighborhoods that are controlled by these gangs, this is not a good change. This is not going to make your life better. It's only going to make it worse. And God forbid these roaming zombie homeless people start forming gangs. Things are going to get real Mad Max in California. Now you might be thinking to yourself, haha, those stupid people in California. What dumbasses. But I don't have to worry about that. I live in a red state. My state isn't run by a bunch of idiots. Well, think about this. How many big US companies are located in California? You're watching YouTube, that's owned by Alphabet, which owns Google, in which all three of those things, YouTube, Alphabet, and Google, are all California companies. There's a good chance that a lot of the companies you do business with are located in California. You know, the types of businesses that have a lot of personal information about you. This, of course, could include things like your bank account number, your social security number, your web search history. Also keep in mind how it seems it's increasingly impossible to get a hold of anyone who can actually solve problems with these companies. Someone's YouTube channel gets taken over, it takes months, if even possible, to get it restored to the original owner. And it seems like more and more businesses are becoming like that. Now, it's my belief that if these social justice warrior prosecutors let these gangs do whatever they want, they're gonna get bigger and more powerful. They're gonna get bolder and they're gonna try different things. They're gonna try to make as much money as possible. When we think of really big organized crime groups, I'm talking like the Italian mafia that existed in New York, those things all started out as street gangs, but they got increasingly sophisticated until they had actual economic power. Now, if these gangs are able to get really big and powerful, if they're able to hack into these companies or gain control of them through extortion, then we could get into a serious crisis that would affect a lot more people than just those who live in California. Failure to enforce gang laws also forecloses any chance that Antifa will ever be prosecuted or dismantled as an organization, which is already a problem because they've seemed to have operated with impunity in California several times before. After refusing to file gang charges out of racism, the natural next step for these social justice warrior prosecutors to take would be to dismantle California's gang database. Now, this is what they did in Chicago, and I covered that in my video that I did recently, criticizing Kim Fox, the Jussie Smollett prosecutor. To summarize that video, Kim Fox had the Chicago gang database completely dismantled. Decades of police work documenting gang members, collecting intelligence on these gangs, writing histories of them, keeping track of what was going on, all of that was destroyed by Kim Fox. As a result of the dismantling of the Chicago gang database, the crime rate in Chicago has skyrocketed. Like Los Angeles, Chicago is the home place of some of America's most notorious gangs. I'm talking about gangs like the Black Disciples, the Latin Kings, the Gangster Disciples. The Gangster Disciples, in particular, are well known to travel from Chicago to other states where they engage in identity theft and bank fraud. In this way, Chicago has become almost like a jumping-off board for organized crime. And all indicators seem to point to California following in its footsteps. Like Chicago, California is on the verge of flushing decades upon decades of hard police work, intelligence gathering, and documenting gang members down the toilet. Because what's more important, dealing with the gang problem, sending violent, homicidal people to prison, protecting the community, or lowering disparities in the criminal justice system? As Thomas Sowell writes in his most recent book, Discrimination and Disparities, it's not at all surprising, and in fact should be expected, that certain professions will be dominated by one or two particular ethnic groups. In fact, it would be highly unexpected and surprising if any given occupation group ended up having a fair representation of every single ethnic group equally. That would be highly unusual. It's therefore not surprising that, for example, Jews are overrepresented in the finance industry, that most convenience stores in the United States seem to be owned by or operated by Middle Eastern or Indian immigrants, that most landscapers in the United States are Mexican American. And it's not at all surprising that there are disparities in what ethnic groups and what racial groups are involved in crime. That's to be expected given the different histories that different ethnic and racial groups have had in the United States. It's not indicative of any sort of racism or discrimination in our society. If all ethnic groups were convicted of crimes at the same rate, that would be highly unusual and indicative of something very unusual going on in US society. Trying to engineer our criminal justice system so that it achieves this outcome by not prosecuting certain people, by not prosecuting certain crimes, is a recipe for disaster. It's setting the system up to do something that's entirely unnatural. It's this sort of social justice warrior tinkering that has brought the hobo apocalypse on the California. It's what's brought the reemergence of medieval diseases like typhus. And so long as California keeps tinkering, as long as they keep going on this experiment that's guaranteed to fail, things are only going to get worse. I think the things that our contemporary society seems to value more highly over everything else says a lot about the decline of our civilization. That being said, there's still something that you can do about this. Support the traditional American Christmas by supporting this YouTube channel. Hit the like button, leave a comment, and if you're not already subscribed, please subscribe. Merry Christmas.